In this problem, I want to determine the empirical formula for a compound when what I'm given is from combustion analysis, how much carbon dioxide, how much water forms. And so the idea is that I'm going to react something that CXHYOZ, react it with oxygen with some stoichiometric coefficient that I don't know. I'm going to make CO2 and water as the two products. 3.095 grams CO2, 1.902 grams of water. And we start it with 1.621 grams of the unknown compound. Essentially, I want to determine X, Y, and Z, where these are integer values, the smallest integer values. Doesn't give us the actual chemical formula, but the empirical formula has the right ratio of carbon to hydrogen to oxygen. What I need to do is determine first, so this is the mass, I need to determine the number of moles of water and of CO2 in order to determine the number of moles of carbon and hydrogen in my starting compound. What I'm going to do is 3.095 grams of CO2. We use the molecular weight for CO2. So grams of CO2 per mole, and that's going to give me the moles of CO2. So I'm going to look up the atomic weights. I'm going to substitute this value in here. That'll allow me to determine the number of moles of CO2. And likewise, 1.902 grams of water. And I realize I just put down molecular weight for carbon. I need to put in here molecular weight for CO2. So let me write CO2, the molecular mass. It's going to be one carbon plus two oxygens. So molecular weight for CO2. And then I'm going to do the same calculation, grams of water per mole, so I can determine the moles of water. And so I can put the molecular mass of water, and then I can calculate the number of moles of each of these components. So here's the numbers using a calculator, the moles of CO2, the moles of water formed. And so this means that in my starting compound had 0.703 moles of carbon. And it means in the starting compound at 0.1056 times 2 moles of hydrogen, because there's 2 moles of hydrogen atoms for every mole of water. And so number of moles of carbon, number of moles of hydrogen, I can use to then determine the mass. So I want the mass so I can determine the mass of oxygen. So 0.0703 moles of carbon times 12.01 grams of carbon per mole of carbon. And units cancel. This is the grams of carbon in that unknown compound. And I'm going to do the same thing. So I did this multiplication. And now I'm going to multiply this by 1.008 grams of hydrogen per mole of hydrogen. It's going to be the grams of hydrogen in my starting unknown compound. So I have the grams of carbon, the grams of hydrogen, and I know that the total grams of the starting compound, 1.621 grams. I can then calculate the grams of oxygen. So the grams of oxygen atoms would be our total minus the number of grams of carbon minus number of grams of hydrogen. So I calculate the grams of oxygen, and now I can take the grams of oxygen, convert this to moles of oxygen, 15.999 grams of oxygen per 1 mole of oxygen. So now I have the number of moles of oxygen. We make a list of the element. So carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and the number of moles. So carbon, 0.0703. Hydrogen is 2 times 0.1056, or 0.2112 moles of hydrogen, and we just calculate the number of moles of oxygen. So if I want to get the minimum integer ratios, I divide each of these numbers by 0.0352. This would be 1, this is pretty close to 2, and this number. And so then our empirical formula would be C2H6O.